So, does National Parts Depot sell this transmission? Nope, they don't. But they do sell pretty much everything that goes around it, from cross members to shifters to shift arms and linkages, even stuff to make the Prindle work with one of these transmissions. So if you need parts for your classic car, you might want to look at National Parts Depot. They have 4 convenient locations across the United States of America. They have one in Ocala, Florida, another in Charlotte, North Carolina, yet another in Detroit, Michigan, and one in Los Angeles, California. Now, from these 4 convenient locations, they can get the parts to you within 3 to 4 business days anywhere within the 48 contiguous states. The cool thing is they also are open 24 hours a day on their phone banks. You can call in any time of the day, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, nearly 365 days a year, and get somebody to chat with about the parts you need for your classic car. They also have an excellent website that if you're not available to do that, you can actually order the parts online and get them shipped out to you pretty much anywhere in the world. What's not to like? We like working with National Parts Depot. They're super nice people, very knowledgeable about the hobby and about the cars that they work on. We use them and we think you should too. All right, so we have our Wildfire lift here, and I'm gonna tell you right now, this is a convenience that I really, really like having around. And what I will say is this, is you can do what we're gonna be doing here with cribbing. You can build a crib, not like, you know, yo crib, but you can build a crib to put your car on to lift it up enough to get the transmission underneath it. Now, what you're gonna have to keep in mind of is when you're doing that, if you're using a transmission floor jack, one of the shorter ones, you could run into problems getting it all the way up to the height you need once you put it underneath there for the cribbing, because you're going to have the case height of the transmission plus the transmission jack. So you'll need to know what all of that is before you set your cribbing up so that you can crab that thing up underneath there. It's going to be pretty tall. And I tell you this, don't build it with anything but like 4x4s. You want this thing to be strong. 6x6s are better. Railroad ties are the best. And what you're going to want to do is set it underneath your tire so the car is just sitting on the suspension up in the air. It'll make your life a lot easier if you do that. Trying to do this with jack stands, A, you're not going to probably have enough room to pick the car up where it needs to be to get the transmission underneath there, and B, you could have problems with motion with it falling off of the jack stands. With the cribbing, if you build your cribbing correctly, you should not have any issues with that. You should be able to have it so that the cribbing is set up so that you have a block between the front and back of the tire on all 4 corners. It's not going to go anywhere if you do this correctly. I'm not going to tell you what kind of cribbing to do this. Now that I got a lift, I'm not doing cribbing.
All right, so we have already gotten all of the basic connecting things taken off the transmission, shift linkages, speedo cable, trans line. All we have left is a vacuum modulator and the torque converter nuts. So I'm gonna go ahead and start taking the torque converter nuts off. They are 9/16ths. There are 4 of them in your flex plate. And we are also using the starter to bump it over just to get them exposed. Now, if you had a permanent magnet, which is the original Ford style starter, it's going to be a little bit harder because you're going to have to jump it from the starter solenoid in the engine bay, but we have a small gear reduction one which has a solenoid built in that we can jump. So let's break these loose and probably slice my hand open on something sharp, because that's just how it goes. That is one. Thanks to TV Magic, I already removed the other 2, so we are good to go. Next up is taking the vacuum modulator line off and then taking bolts out. All right, so I also have to pull the starter off in order to pull the transmission. Now we have some 12-point fasteners on this, and this is not the original starter to it. This is a torque reduction or a gear reduction starter. So, oh, that was loose. We have already disconnected the battery cables, which is a very smart idea if you do not want to make sparks. Right. That one. I'm going to loosen this one. and then actually thread my bottom one back in so the starter does not fall on my face. It only takes one time to learn that trick. Twelve-point bolts look great, but they are very bad if you have oily fingers. All right, that one's out. Now I'm going to get some zip ties and probably zip tie this up to the tie rod ends so that it is not dangling on the cables. But that is out, so we are good to go ahead and pull the rest of it.
Okay, so what we got to do now is we've taken the modulator loose from the intake manifold. Anytime you got a C4, C6, any of those that have a vacuum modulator on it, on a Ford, you're going to need to take that loose because we're going to pull the modulator line off in a second. And it can be a lot of fun. Cam had so much fun taking that one off. But remember, always cap it after you get done. As soon as you take that vacuum line off, if you're adding an AOD to the car, you're not going to put a modulator back on there. So you need to take and get a cap for it so that you don't have a vacuum leak whenever you go to start the car after you get everything done. So there's your hot tech tip for that.
All right, so next up is the bell housing bolts. We have already got these two on this side loose. The top ones are removed. We had to get it from the top just because of access with a 351 Cleveland, a little bit tighter than stock. So we couldn't get a socket on it from the bottom. So we're gonna show you the left-hand side because that's the one that's easy to show you. The right hand is a lot tighter on this one. So it is just a 5/8, a couple extensions, and throw the socket across the shop. Because that's how swivels work. All right, I'm just leaving the bottom ones loose because we're going to have to set a jack on the bottom of this trans to support it. There are dowels in the case that are going to hold it up, that are going to hold it where it's at right now and won't let it fall off while the bolts are coming out. All right, that one is out. So we're going to go ahead and get the jack set up. And we'd be able to drop this thing.
Whee.
All right, so we've got the jack bridge in place supporting the transmission pan. That's just to hold it up while we take the back transmission mount out. So I'm going to take these two nuts off. And I did pre-loosen these because TV magic. It's a real thing. And all of the bell housing bolts are out right now, so technically it is no longer attached to the car. Take the outer ones off. Once the second one is off, the whole brace will drop down out of our way. And we'll be good to drop the transmission, hopefully not straight to the floor.
Hey.
All right, so we have the jack bridge up in place. 2x4 is holding the transmission up. Transmission cross member is out. So next up is walking the transmission back. If we had an actual transmission jack, this would be a little bit safer, but this C4 and C6s are relatively light, so this isn't a big deal. Jeff is up front with a screwdriver that he's just gonna use to make sure that the torque converter does not come out of the front seal. If the studs get stuck on the flex plate, the torque converter can stay with the flex plate and you, it's a bad day for your pavement.
We've already kind of had one of those.
Yes.
The torque we pulled the dipstick tube. It kind of, yeah. It rained. It's good. Beautifully.
My leg is still wet.
And will be.
Yes, for days. All right, so
this
he's going
to be so nice there.
Yes. So smooth. So he's going to make sure the torque converter doesn't come out while I move the transmission back. As soon as the torque converter clears the flex plate, we're going to drop it down and figure out where to next. Alrighty.
You're off on the bottom.
Something's holding me.
Not me.
Firewall. Are we clear of...
Yeah, you're clear of the...
Okay, I'm going to drop it down slowly. And feel for the torque converter catching.
Looking good down here.
Something's holding it. No, it's free. All right, And again, this is because we've got a Cleveland in here. I may go in and do a few firewall modifications.
Smackings. Firewall with, smackings is what you...
with Meow Meow a little later on, our 5-pound sledge, just so we can have a little more room for bolting and things like that. Going in the wrong direction.
Yeah, well, I can't go down.
Oh, well, that's a bit fine.
Right, so
clear.
I'm going to drop it all the way down.
So
our next step is getting either a piece of wire or a piece of metal in front of that torque converter across the bell housing so it physically cannot leave. And
at least in theory.
Yeah. So that'll save us much kitty litter. All right.
We got a cat, so we got plenty of kitty litter.
You just make sure it doesn't rock off the shaft. To make torque, make sure this
yeah,
hold,
make sure it's
hold the torque converter into it.
Yep.
And pull it back. So we have access. Let me go pull this line out since we.
Bye bye, modulator line. And leaf, apparently.
It was its friend.
All right, you're up against the firewall again.
Yep. All right, so we're going to go ahead and get that torque converter plate in. And then pick this thing up.
Yay! I guess.
Our torque converter holding tool in place, which is a little piece of scrap aluminum that we had. So I'm going to pull the back of the transmission down and we're going to shimmy it off the 2x4s and then work it out and hopefully not drop it. That is the main goal. It's good to go with basic goals.
If you say that's a basic goal, I'm good with it.
All right. You should be able to...
Hang on. Front block out.
All right, now we're gonna rock the trans forward. Watch that torque converter to make sure it doesn't plop you in the head.
It shouldn't, because it's got that piece of aluminum on it.
Okay. So now we can pull the jack back a bit further. All right, you wanna switch places with me because it's about to tip over. We don't need
down.
That.
Luckily, we won't need that.
All right.
So you want me to switch places with you?
Yeah.
Right. Well, Ow. You got both of us.
Ow, that thunked me good.
Right in the top of the head, too. Ow.
Okay.
Okay, now what? So you're going to be holding that end of it.
Yep, I'm holding this side up, and you're going to shimmy the jack back.
Toward me.
Yep, and then we're going to set it on the floor.
So in other words, I'm going to take the jack further back with the transmission right where it's sitting.
Yes, I'm going to hold the transmission here.
Okay.
Once it comes off the pan, it's probably going to be a little bit scary.
You want to pull back on the jack more?
Yep, keep going. Right. Here you go.
What are we doing?
Pull back on the jack.
Okay.
All right. Okay.
Because the transmission's coming out of the bottom. We're going to lose it in three.
I got it. Let's slide it back. Ooh, I'm taking a bath. All right. Okay. I keep going. All right. Now come around this side.
Yep.
Get it past that. Okay. Did you get a bath too?
Yeah, not yet, but it's working on it.
All right, we're off the chain.
I'm glad you got the heavy in.
Yep.
Okay. Whew. I think I'm about to buy you a new shirt.
New shirt, new pants.
New wardrobe.
Ooh. I knew I should have worn work clothes.
That is how you remove a jack, an unsafe way.
Yeah, we want a transmission jack. We've got one on order. It's not in yet. It would have been tons easier doing this with a transmission jack, and I always recommend getting a transmission jack when you're doing it.
But this goes to show that it is possible by hand. While not fun and not safe, I have a big cut on my finger now.
You okay?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Nothing like ATF and grime won't hurt or help.
All right. Well, now we just need to...
470W time.
Yeah.
Woohoo!
Well, that's next.
And cleaning time.
I think we'll do that next week. This was enough stress. All right, folks. Well, that's our show for this week, ladies and gentlemen. You guys have a great week, and we'll see you next time on
Autorestomod. I'm going to go find a bath or a lake.
I'm supposed to...
I think the lake will work better.
I'll just tell you what. I'll put you out in the backyard and hose you off.
Let's wait for it to rain.
Yes.